Hello, everyone. This is Sebastian signing in for Sinking Ship, the show, little tiny show where we talk about stuff and things. Not to be confused with stuffing things, so if you came here for that kind of thing, you are at the wrong place. Anyway, let me tell you all about my week. I got a haircut the other day, and I started working out this week, which, let me tell you, sucks. Now, our theme for this week is favorite book, and as a reader, I've often been asked, what is my favorite book? And I found myself just dribbling over all of my favorite books until the asker loses interest and leaves. Like most people, I have a few favorite books. There's The Catcher in the Rye, there's The Sirens of Titan, Blood Meridian, Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close, The Sun Also Rises, The Great Freaking Gatsby, Looking for Alaska, which is Jason's favorite book. He just talked about yesterday. Funny thing, he's the one who got me into this book and got me turned on to Nerdfighteria. But my absolute favorite book, hands down, is East of Eden by John Steinbeck. And a little backstory about the book. I actually found it at a little used bookstore that I often frequent. And before then, I had never heard about it before. I've read a lot of books and, you know, this one just never crossed anything. And then I asked a little old lady, because it's run by little old ladies, because I figured they know a thing or two about books, because they've been around the block a few times. And I asked her, do you have any recommendations? And she said, you should read this book. It's very, very good. And at $2, how could I pass up the chance? And it just blew me away. Up until then... I had never read anything so beautiful, so perfect, that it just drastically changed the way I looked at literature. And like the old lady, I've recommended the book quite a few times to many of my friends. As a matter of fact, the other day I bought the book for my friend. Not the same cover, but it was $1, so I bought it for him, and he didn't have any cash, so why not? I'm sharing the gift of reading. And if I'm not mistaken, I may have bought it for Jason, too. I think so, but he'd have to verify that. And I'm super happy because this summer he's actually going to read it. And while he's doing that, I'm actually going to reread it myself. That way we can both talk about it afterwards. Now, the biggest theme in this book is Timshel, which means thou mayest. Thou mayest what? It has to do with the conquest of good and evil, or the choice between good and evil. Thou mayest choose to vanquish evil and follow the good path, or thou mayest choose the dark path. I'm going to read you a little clip from the foreword. Adam Trask came to California from the east to farm and raise his family on the new, rich land. But the birth of his twins, Cal and Aaron, brings his wife to the brink of madness, and Adam is left alone to raise his boys to manhood. One boy thrives, nurtured by the love of all those around him. The other grows up in loneliness, enveloped by a mysterious darkness. As you can see from that, especially with the names Cal and Aaron, this story is going to be about Cain and Abel. And really, the story is about finding acceptance in a world that may not want you. And I've said it time and time again, and I will say it again right now, that Steinbeck had a gift for painting just the most beautiful pictures. And this book, when it's over, I just felt such a melancholic emptiness. That's the best way I can put it. That I just didn't know what to feel afterwards. I felt sad, but I also felt nothing. And I think that's the best feeling after you finish reading a book. And with that, I'll leave you, because to try to explain this book in less than a minute or two would just insult the whole thing. Just go out and read it, but my advice to you is, if you're trying to look for something just to pick up, put down every now and then, don't try to read it. This has to be something that you dedicate a lot of time to. I mean, look, it's a pretty meaty book. It took me so long to read it just because I wanted to read it slowly so I could digest everything. Because at the end, it just crushes you. Just like a tidal wave. That's pretty much what it is. The build up, then at the end when it all crashes down. So with that, I will see you tomorrow, Kayla. And for everyone watching this, Tim Schell.